Hello friends, how are you all? This is Praful and I welcome you all to One Page Biology. So in today's video, we are going to talk about a very interesting topic. The name of the topic is ECG. You must have heard about this particular term ECG somewhere or the other. Maybe your parents must have performed this particular test, or sometimes even you might have performed this test. So do you know all that why do we perform this particular test? And what is the actual significance or advantage of this particular test? So don't worry, dear students, in this particular video, you will be getting full explanation about what exactly is ECG. And I'm sure that at the end of this video, you will be clear with the concept of what exactly is ECG. Also friends, this particular topic, ECG, is part of the chapter body fluids and circulation in your 11th standard NCERT biology. As far as 12th textbook is concerned, it is part of some of the state board syllabus. Like for example, it is part of Maharashtra board syllabus also. So let's understand this particular topic of what exactly is ECG. So now dear students, as you all can see, there is this particular patient who is performing this ECG. First of all, in ECG, what happens is, in this particular test, the doctor fixes some wires on our body, and these wires are placed most of the times in our chest area. Sometimes the electrical wires are also placed on our ankles. The full form of ECG is actually electrocardiograph. So electrocardiograph is actually the monitor or the machine which actually records the impulses. Most of the times, dear students, in movies we have seen that whenever the patient is doing the ECG, there is a monitor right beside him. And in that particular monitor, we can see that there are multiple graph-like structures which are coming in. So that instrument which shows the graphs, that instrument is called as electrocardiograph. Those graphs which we can see, those graphs are called as electrocardiogram. So here it is slightly reverse. In fact, the instrument is called as electrocardiograph, and the graphs what we see in that instrument, they are known as electrocardiograms. So let us understand who actually invented this particular instrument. Now, dear students, the father of ECG was nothing but William Einthoven. So basically, William Einthoven had invented this particular instrument called as ECG in the year 1895. And of course, for inventing this, he had also received a Nobel Prize, which was in the field of physiology or medicine, back in the year 1924. Now let us understand what is the job of this particular instrument. Now, as we all know that in our body, the most important organ, which is heart, it is constantly contracting and relaxing. So the question is, why does the heart continuously contract and relax? Basically, the reason is, as we all know that heart keeps on pumping pure blood throughout the body. So continuously, dear students, heart is constantly supplying the oxygenated blood to all the different parts of our body. And that's why, dear students, all the different parts are able to function properly. Now, dear students, whenever the heart is constantly pumping the blood, there are two basic movements which are occurring in the heart. And that is nothing but contraction and relaxation. That means heart is actually continuously contracting and relaxing, contracting and relaxing. So, dear students, these particular movement, that is contraction and relaxation, these are also called as, in biological language, systole and diastole. That means contraction is also called as systole and relaxation is also called as diastole. Now the question is, dear students, how does heart exactly contract and relax? So how is the heart able to create such a pressure inside it so that it can continuously contract and relax, contract and relax? The answer is, dear students, there is an impulse which is generated inside our heart. So it is because of this particular impulse that a force is created inside our heart, because of which the heart can constantly contract and relax. So heart, in a way, generates its own impulse. Dear students, if you want to understand what exactly is an impulse, I had made a separate video on what exactly is a nerve impulse. So make sure that you guys watch that particular video. Now coming back to the topic, as we said that heart generates its own impulse. So this impulse, dear students, helps the heart to continuously contract and relax. So heart basically has got four basic chambers. The upper two chambers are known as the two atrium and the lower two chambers are known as the two ventricles. So actually, inside the heart, the impulse is created inside the atrium, dear students. And that too, exactly inside the right atrium. That means the upper right compartment of the heart, which is known as the right atrium. Inside the right atrium, the impulse is generated. And who generates this impulse? So there is a small muscle inside the right atrium, which is actually known as SA node. The full form of SA node is sinoatrial node. And once the SA node generates that impulse travels through the atrium, and from the atrium, it reaches to the ventricles also. And that's how the impulse spreads throughout basically the ventricles. So the question is, what this impulse is doing? So dear students, as this impulse actually passes through the atrium, through the walls of the walls of the atrium are going to contract. And this process of spreading of the impulse throughout the atrium, this process is known as atrial depolarization. That means whenever the nerve impulse passes throughout the atrium, that process is known as atrial depolarization. At the same time, whenever the impulse spreads throughout the ventricles, that process is called as ventricular depolarization. So this particular impulse, which is passing first through the atrium and then further it reaches to the ventricles, can be recorded. And this impulse is actually recorded via the instrument which is known as electrocardiograph. So as we said in the beginning, dear students, inside that monitor, we can see continuously graph-like structures which are passing. So that graph is known as electrocardiogram. And in that graph, we can see certain waves which are formed. And these waves are nothing but the recording of basically the nerve impulse which is passing through our heart. So dear students, now let me tell you that inside that graph, which is basically electrocardiogram, what are these waves indicating? Now first of all, there are three basic waves which can be seen in the electrocardiogram. Of course, there is a fourth wave also, but as far as the syllabus is concerned, as far as the NEET syllabus is concerned, dear students, in that we have to only study the three waves which are mentioned in our 11th NCERT textbook. So let us focus only on those three waves. What are these three waves? The first wave is known as P wave. What is P wave indicating? So the P wave is actually a recording of the impulse which is passing through the atrium. So what is that impulse called, dear students? That is known as atrial depolarization. Similarly, dear students, there is a big wave which is been shown on the electrocardiogram. What is that wave? That is QRS complex. So this QRS complex is nothing but the indication of the nerve impulse which is passing through the ventricles. So what is that nerve impulse called? That will be called as ventricular depolarization. And finally, again, there is a small wave which is seen after the QRS complex. What is that wave indicating? That wave is indicating that the ventricles are relaxing, and that is nothing but the T wave. The T wave is indicating ventricular repolarization. That means the nerve impulse has already passed from the ventricles and now the ventricles are coming back to the rest. So total, dear students, how many waves are there in the ECG? These are nothing but the P waves, the QRS complex, as well as the T wave. Now, dear students, sometimes there are often cases wherein this ECG can be slightly different than the ECG of a healthy person. Like for example, there is a condition which is called as coronary ischemia. Now in coronary ischemia, the heart is not able to function properly. And this generally happens because the coronary artery, which is a very important artery which supplies the oxygenated blood to our heart, gets blocked. And why does it get blocked? It is getting blocked because of the deposition of the fat inside the coronary arteries. And often because of that, the person might also get a heart attack. So basically, by carrying out a ECG of the person, one can very easily find out whether the heart is functioning normally or it is not able to function properly. So if the ECG of a person is showing the proper graph, that is a proper P wave, a QRS complex, as well as the T wave, that is an indication that person's heart is working properly. But dear student, in any case, if a particular wave, specifically guys, the T wave is slightly smaller, or for example, if the T wave gets flattened, that is a high indication that the heart is not functioning well. So now, based on this concept, dear students, there was this particular question which was asked in NEET 2019. What was that question? Now, this question was basically of match the column type. So as you can see that there are two columns. In column number one, there is P wave, QRS complex, T wave, and the fourth option is reduction in the size of T wave. Whereas in the column 2, the options are depolarization of ventricles, repolarization of ventricles, coronary ischemia, depolarization of atria, and the last option is repolarization of atria. So we have to match column 1 with the right options of column 2. Now I am pretty sure, dear students, that you will be able to answer this question. So what is a P wave indicating? Of course, the P wave is indicating depolarization of atria. As we said that the P wave indicates the nerve impulse when it is passing from the atria, it is called as depolarization of atria. Same way, QRS complex is indicating the depolarization of ventricles. T wave is indicating the repolarization of ventricle. That means it is indicating the relaxation of ventricles. And the last, that is the reduction in the size of T wave. As we said that this is an ECG of a person who is suffering from heart disease. So this occurs whenever there is a disease like coronary ischemia. So whenever the coronary artery of the heart gets blocked due to the fatty deposits, in that case, the size of the T wave might reduce. So dear students, I hope you have understood today's concept of ECG. And I'm sure that based on this concept, you will be able to solve different MCQs also. If you have any doubts or suggestions, please let me know in the comment section. If you have understood the topic, dear students, please like, share and subscribe to One Page Biology. See you all in the next video with some other biology related concept, dear students. Thank you so much. Bye bye. Take care.